Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Sorry there's been a bit of delay in content. Both myself and Bailey have been on holiday and we're also on a job which we haven't got permission to film, unfortunately. But we're back now at the rural renovation and we're going to start putting the bathrooms in. Okay, so this is a top floor bathroom and as you can see it's all tiled now. There's going to be beading going on the walls to give it that traditional look, but that's going to be put on afterwards. So we're actually going to start on the bath and the freestanding taps so we can get that done, and then that'll be out of the way of the toilet and the basin we're going to be fitting. So as you can see down here, we've got the waste pipe lined up poking through the floor, so that should just poke through the void in the bottom of the bath. And then originally, if you watched the previous chapters in this video, you would have seen I run the bath feeds in 15 mil, which I'll show you in a minute why. And yeah, we'll get the freestanding taps out and get them fit first. So we're just setting up the bath taps. Now, depending on the height of your bath, you need to adjust the legs to suit accordingly and also the pipe work. So what happens is your hot and cold feeds will run up these two legs here, and then you've got these telescopic sections which you can adjust up and down to suit the height of the bath. So because I installed 15 mil hot and cold feeds, it gives us more room when we're trying to poke the pipe work through here. So if you do that in 22 mil, it makes it very difficult to get it 100% accurate. So the copper pipe's gonna run up through there, and then we can adjust these telescopic sections on the top to suit the pipe work and to suit the height of the bath. So first thing we need to do is get the bath in. So we just lifted this up two stories. Luckily, it's nice and light. The reason we've got the bath in first is we need to determine how high the taps need to be set. So we've got the bath in, and then we can start setting up the taps. So unfortunately, while we've been setting up these taps, we've realised they're actually deck mounted taps, not freestanding taps, which has given us a bit of a problem. So we should still be able to use them, but it just makes our installation a lot more difficult. So what we've done is we've had to slide the chrome legs over first and keep the pipes rigid rather than flexible, and we're just getting our copper tap connectors on now, so it just makes it a little bit more tricky. So this tap here and these chrome fittings are actually designed for the tap to be mounted on the top of the bath, and then you'd have this chrome section which hides the pipes and screws in underneath. But we're having to make do with what we've got, as these have been sitting on site for a long time now and the pipe centers are all set up for them. So once this is all done, we can mark the holes for our securing screws underneath and get that all bolted in. Right, okay, so we've got the feet or the legs all screwed into the floor now, and what we kind of aimed to do was to get these totally level across. So this part of the chrome leg is actually telescopic, and what will happen is we'll tighten up this onto the tap connection to make sure the water's flowing through, and then this section here will just slide over to hide all the nasty pipe work. And then inside the top of here, you've got a female thread which will then tighten up onto the bottom here, onto that female thread, and make everything nice and secure.
Put the thing on.
Push that red button. 10 years later. Yeah.
Okay, so the bath tap's all in position now, everything's nice and secure. All I've got to do now is just swap out the white handles and white handset for a black one. So I'm going to be putting these black levers on. I just need to tweak the insert, so I don't know if any of you ever find this, but whenever I come to fit any taps or shower valves with levers on, they're always a little bit pierced, so you just have to take them shrouds off here, tweak the inserts to get them just right. So I'll get them swapped over and then this tap will be done. So we've got all the black levers on now and we've just offered the bath up into position and it looks really good. The only issue we've got is the black overflow isn't on site, so we can't actually finish this part of the job. So we'll just leave the bath where it is at the moment, so kind of see where it's going to be when it's finished. And in the meantime, we're just going to start moving on. So we're going to start putting this towel rail in position. And this really helps if your first fix is absolutely accurate, because you get absolutely no play on these type of traditional radiators. So Bailey's done a good job, it's all ready to go, just got to put a load of screws into the floor and into the wall to keep that nice and secure. And then over here on the right, start moving on to the basin. So I've got all the components together for the chrome cradle that's going to be supporting the Burlington sink. So I just need to get this built and then I can offer it up to the wall, get it centered and then get it secured to the wall. Okay, so I've got the cradle mounted now and what I've done is I've actually put the level across the chrome legs just to make sure the fixings on the back wall are totally straight, and also it means that the sink's going to be level when I'm finished. So I'll just show you what I've done. So where I've started is I've marked the center of the waste and then I've put a line either side to determine the distance apart from the chrome fixings here. And then if you can see, if that zooms in on this chrome fixing here, I've marked the center line horizontal and also the center line vertically, so I know exactly where I need to fix it to ensure that all these chrome legs and arms are all totally level. Okay, so I've got the cradle mounted to the wall now and I just need to get the fixings into the floor. So in the bottom of these legs you have a hollow point and then you attach these brass fins to the floor and then these legs will lift up, sit over the top of them, and that just prevents it from moving back and forth. So now I've got the cradle mounted to the wall and the floor, I'm just checking these chrome spigots to make sure they're level across. So you have little adjustments on them, which you can see here. You just spin these wheels up and down and then you can ensure that your sink's going to be totally level when it goes on. Before I actually put the sink on though, I will be putting my isolation valves and chrome shrouds over these copper pipes here. Just makes it a lot easier to do it beforehand. So we're on to the next part of the job and that's installing the basin taps. Now normally that would be quite straightforward, but this unfortunately has one of those rotted wastes which can be quite tricky, and also it's got three holes with a single outlet, so it's all piped up into each other underneath, so it's not as straightforward as just fitting a set of basin taps. So I really hate fitting rotted wastes, I think they're a pain, they never tend to work properly, but they do look fancy and traditional. So underneath, so while I was messing around with the basin, Bailey's managed to get the toilet in. It's paired with a black toilet seat and also we've got a black cistern handle on it, so it matches the rest of the bathroom. If you had watched us first fixing this, you would have seen we was first fixing it with a closed couple toilet, but that actually got changed to a back to the wall one. But fortunately enough, the pipe wire lines up pretty good, so we've just about got away with it.